Hey YouTube, and welcome back to another video. Today, I want to talk to you guys about how I got better at Fortnite and how you can keep improving too. This is a topic that I've seen a few other big tips and tricks YouTubers go over, and I think these kinds of videos are super helpful, so I wanted to bring you guys my version of that today. Now, by no means am I a pro player or even close to that level, but in the past few months, I've improved really dramatically at Fortnite, so I wanted to show you guys how that all happened. If you all remember my gameplay from some of my older videos, or you just take a look back at them now, you'll see how much worse I was just a few months ago compared to today. So today, I'm going to go over that transformation, and hopefully you guys can pick up on some ways that you can improve as well. As always, I'll have timestamps in the description below that split this video up into the different topics I'll go over, so feel free to jump between different sections of the video as you see fit. Alright, without wasting any more time, let's talk about how I improved at Fortnite. The first thing I did when I decided I really wanted to get better at this game was probably the most obvious thing, but it is by far the most important, and that is I had to figure out what I didn't know how to do. In other words, what I had to do was figure out what was keeping me back every game, why I was dying, and what I actually needed to improve on. This step is really important, and it is honestly overlooked by so many people. So what I did was after I died every game, I would think about the reason, and then I could go actually fix that aspect of my game. For example, one of the biggest things that I noticed that was holding me back was that I couldn't keep up in build fights, and it was really hard for me to do 90s because my keybinds were poorly optimized. So what I had to do was address that part of my game by taking the time to relearn my keybinds so that I could get better. Now this is just one example of something I improved on, and there are many things I did besides that, but this is the process you need to go through if you want to improve. Think about what caused you to die, and then go and work on improving that part of your game. Maybe you messed up an edit, maybe you just had bad aim, or maybe you were in a final circle and you didn't know what to do because you don't have a lot of game sense yet. Whatever it is, focus on specifically addressing that part of the game. I'll talk more about the best ways to fix some of these issues later, but definitely the first thing you should do is figure out your strengths and weaknesses. The second tip that helped me improve a lot was watching players that were slightly better than me play the game. And the keyword there is slightly. Just like with the last tip, one of the ways you can figure out your weaknesses and find new ways to improve is by watching players that are better than you. But if you really want to learn and improve the fastest, the key is that you are watching players that are slightly and not way better than you. The reason for this is that we're all at different skill levels in Fortnite, and we all have different strengths and weaknesses. If you're just an average player looking to improve, watching somebody that is crazy at the game like Booga isn't going to do you that much good, because odds are you aren't going to actually be picking up on a lot of the things he is doing because he is so much better. Instead, I would recommend looking for players that are slightly better than you, and not too much better. That way, you can actually pick up on what they're doing and start to adopt some of their strategies yourself. For me, one of the best players I like to watch is CypherPK, and to this day, I keep watching him to improve because he is a player that is definitely better than me, but I can still keep up with his gameplay and pick up on what he's doing. So what I'd recommend for you guys is to find someone who is slightly better than you and really pay attention to their gameplay. With time, you'll start to pick up on what they do that you don't, and you can slowly start to incorporate that into your gameplay to improve. One last thing I want to say when watching gameplay is that you should be careful not to get too caught up with random tips and tricks videos that show you how to face into people's boxes and show you other niche tricks like that. If you want to get better, it's not going to happen by learning some new phasing technique. It's going to come from practicing bigger parts of your game, like improving your editing, aim, game sense, and all of that. The third thing I did to improve once I had watched a lot of gameplay and figured out my weak spots was I had to find the best ways to practice. Now for me, I decided that my strengths were that I had good aim and good game sense, but my weaknesses were that I couldn't build very fast and I had slow edits. So to fix these issues, I decided that the best way to improve would be to grind out creative editing and build maps, and it was crazy how quickly I got better. If you're like me and your weaknesses have to do with your mechanics, like building, editing, or aiming, then by far the best thing to do is run through creative practice courses. Just by doing courses for 20 to 30 minutes a day, my editing and building improved more than they would have if I had played actual matches all day long. At this point, I'm a believer that the best way to improve at Fortnite is not by actually playing out matches, it's by grinding out creative maps, because they allow you to pinpoint your weaknesses and work specifically on fixing them. So whatever your weaknesses are, find a creative map that will help you work on them and grind the map out for a little while each day. I'll link a map below that I use, made by Tito, that will allow you to practice aim, edits, and building. So if any of those are your problems, I'd highly recommend you check it out. It's what helped me improve more in the past month than I have in my whole time playing Fortnite. So trust me, practice for a little bit on this course every day, and you'll be thankful you did. The last thing I did to improve after I'd figured out my weaknesses and I had spent a good amount of time practicing was jump into real in-game situations and try to apply what I had learned. The big thing here though that I noticed was that it wasn't a very good use of my time to play squads or trios or anything like that to improve. Whenever I played squads, everything was so wild and out of control that I couldn't actually apply what I had learned in my games and practice real build fight situations. Instead, the best way to improve for me was to play for the win in solo games. What I would do is I would loot up, get mats, and then only go and look for fights after that. This way, I could actually apply all the techniques I learned in practice in creative into my fights. One last thing I will say is that once you practice your mechanics and you feel comfortable with them, you should really start trying to focus on playing for the win in these solo matches. Because the only way you're going to get solid game sense and get comfortable in intense situations is by making smart decisions over and over again, taking the right fights, and getting used to the flow of the game, rotations, positioning, and all of that. Sure, creative will get you mechanically skilled, but if you want to reach that end goal of getting wins, try to start picking and choosing your fights and developing that game sense. If you can get both your mechanics and that game sense down, you'll turn into a whole new player and you'll be unstoppable in your games. Okay guys, those are the four big things I did to improve. Hopefully these tips helped you out, and if you aren't doing any of them, I'd highly recommend you start now and you'll be surprised how quickly you see improvement. Alright guys, that is all I have for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If this video helped you out, you can show me by leaving a like and subscribing if you haven't already. Also, if you have any questions or feedback, let me know in the comment section below and I'll make sure to respond to you. One last thing I want to say is that if you aren't already using my creator code, you can enter my code SpookLuke in the Fortnite shop to really help me out. Other than that, that's all I've got guys. So once again, thanks so much for watching and I'll see you all in the next one. Come in, come in, come in, come in.